Hello, I am Madison, and I am going to be doing a video tutorial on pointillism. Pointillism started in the 1800s in France and was created by
Georges Seurat, French.
Seurat was really inspired by the Impressionists, but he wasn't an Impressionist. He was what you call a Neo-Impressionist. So a Neo-Impressionist is someone who really focuses on the optical illusions of color theory. So when we think of color, we're thinking of the elements of art, okay, primary colors, secondary colors. Typically, what painters were doing before this was created is they were taking two colors, mixing them on a palette, and then putting it onto a canvas. So let's say they were trying to make the color purple. What two colors would they mix? Okay, they would mix blue and red. They would mix it on the palette, and then they would put it onto the canvas. What he did was on the canvas, he put blue and red side by side. He didn't mix them, he just put them side by side. From far away, you looked at his paintings and you said, oh, that's purple. But was it? No, it was not. You stand up closer to the painting and you see that it's actually not purple, but it's blue and red placed very closely together. This kind of style, Neo-Impressionism, developed into what we now know as pointillism. It's the technique of using small dots of color to make a beautiful, vibrant composition. Seurat's most famous painting is called A Sunday Afternoon. Try and guess how long it took to paint this. So now we're going to make a color wheel to kind of warm up. You want to find some kind of circular object that'll fill up the majority of your sketchbook and just trace around it. The pencil, okay? Now you're going to take a ruler. We're going to be creating six of these slices. You want to end up with a color wheel that looks something like this. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 spaces. So for this, we're actually gonna be using paint. You wanna use acrylic paint. Oil will not work for this. Watercolor won't work for this. You really wanna use acrylic. You're also gonna wanna find some kind of plate or palette to put the color on. So I'm just gonna put a little bit more of this yellow out here. Okay, and by the way, these are my three what type of colors? Right, so these are my primary colors. Okay, a little bit more red and a little bit more blue. Okay, so this is also where you have kind of an artistic license to decide how large you want these points to be, these dots. Okay, so let's say you want them to be really small. Okay, well, you would use the tip of something like this, maybe. Okay, so let's just see what that's like. If we use the tip, I'm gonna test it out right there. Okay, so that's pretty small. Okay, now the deal is with small dots, you get a lot of detail. Okay, with detail comes more time. So that's one type of dot. I think this would give us a bigger dot. Let's see. Okay, yep, so it's a little bit bigger. Okay, so the end of a pencil, we're gonna get this size dot. Pretty big. All right, so here's our color wheel. So I'm gonna start off, I've got blue on my tip right here, so I'm just gonna start off with blue. Okay, so these are pretty close together. And every couple dots, you just wanna reapply the paint onto the tip of your tool. Okay, so now that we've done our warm-up, we're gonna move on to the next step. So our actual painting is going to be of a famous monument. So some famous monuments that come to my mind would be the Eiffel Tower in Paris, the Great Wall of China, the pyramids at Giza, the Arc de Triomphe in France. I chose to do the Taj Mahal because I recently visited the Taj Mahal in India, in Agra. So this is a picture of the Taj Mahal in color that I printed off at a UPS store near where I live. Now I've got to decide how big do I want my canvas to be. This is some relatively inexpensive canvas by Artist's Loft that I picked up at Michael's. You know, five of these in a pack, and these are 11 by 14 inch. Now what you're gonna do, you need to decide where on this canvas do you want your monument. So I think I'm gonna center mine because if you look at this image, it's pretty symmetrical. So that would be right around here, okay? And now I'm just gonna flip this over very carefully and trace where it is that I'm gonna cut. Now I'm just going to cut this. Okay. So after I cut this, I'm gonna do what we've done in class before. This is called a graphite transfer. Flip this over, and on the back of the image, we're just gonna go over this, okay? So now I want you to get some tape. When we put this down, we wanna make sure that it does not move. You're gonna take a regular pencil, and you're gonna go over as much detail as you can. I like to go from left to right because if you kind of start over here and then you go back over here and then down here, you kind of forget what you've already gone over. So now what I'm gonna do is just carefully take off this tape and see if what I've got is gonna work. And if it's not, I'll just keep going. So I'm ready to get started. So I've got my palette. I've got a piece of scrap paper so I can test out any colors before I actually put them onto my canvas. I have a tissue to wipe off the paint from my my tool that I'm gonna use. And I've got all my paints. I've decided that I'm gonna do smaller dots because this is such a detailed image that if I use the end of a pencil, it's just gonna be too big. I'm not gonna be able to control the detail that I want. I'm gonna start off with the lighter colors. Almost finished with my Taj Mahal pointillism painting. I hope this video tutorial is helpful, and if you have any questions, feel free to email me. Good luck!